Friends, devotion is English, bhakti is Sanskrit. Devotion is a noble emotion, a pious emotion, a divine emotion. And what is an emotion? An excess of feeling, an overflow of feeling, a flood of feeling. And what is a feeling? Every heart has a feeling. What is a heart? Everybody has it. Every person is blessed with a heart. It is a component, essential component, without which there is no life. A part of the body may be absent. An eye may be absent. Hand may be absent. If the heart is absent, there is no life. There is no person. Every person is endowed with a heart, and every heart has feelings. Feelings are positive, feelings are negative. When the negative feelings are removed and the positive feelings are purified and allowed to flow, it is a divine emotion. When it grows to a great extent, it is devotion. When that devotion is translated into action, it's called worship. Feeling, purification of the feeling, overflow of the feeling, emotion. Emotion becomes devotion. Devotion translated into action is worship. Then, whom do we love? Why do we love? Love is present in every heart. Other feelings may be present, may not be present. Anger may be present, may not be present. Jealousy may be present, may not be present. But every person invariably has one particular feeling. Whom you love, when you love, where you love, how you love, the intensity of love, the expression of love, the language of love, the place of love may change from person to person. But love is never absent. And this love has two sides. Normally people speak of one side only. I love. This is one side of the coin. Why do I love? Because the other person loves me. Love is the only coin which has two sides. Both sides are love. Initially, when you love a person, you love the body. Infatuation. Gradually, you love the love of that person. Love is blind, people say. Yes? It is blind to the feelings, initially only to the body. When the love shifts, you begin to love and you are blind to the body. When you love the body, you may be blind to the heart. When you love the heart and its feelings of the other person, you are blind to the body. In the earlier stages, we love the body. We love the language of the body, the expression. That's called infatuation. As you grow older and older, it is not the body I love. It's not the language I love. I love the person's love. Then I am blind. Old couple, 85 years each. What is it they love each other? Is it the wrinkled body? Is it the dying body? Certainly not. There is something intrinsic. something noble, something divine, and this love of X loves the love of that Y. So love loves life, love. In bhakti, any love, it is God's love. The other side, from my side, it is devotion. From his side, it is grace. Divine grace is love. Individual love is devotion. When the father loves the baby or mother loves the baby, it is called vatsalya. When the child loves, it is love. Mother loves the baby, affection. Teacher loves the baby, student loves the teacher, respect. There is love between the teacher and the student. There is love between God and devotee. There is love between husband and wife. There is love between citizen and the country. What is the bond? Prema. The entire universe is bound by the cosmic love. We all come to this Mangal Mandir because we have some attraction, some love. And this is the intrinsic force. We will in this class see God's love towards us. People have sufficiently spoken about our love to God, our love to the country, our love to the wives or husbands. Husband's love for me or wife's love for me, God's love for me, country's love for me, nature's love for me, the other side of the coin. And doctor is the best doctor. If he loves me, allows me to heal, facilitates healing without medication. He is the best doctor, or she is the best doctor, who is capable of healing, giving good health without medication. Who is the best teacher? He or she is the best teacher who facilitates learning without instruction. Who is that best master? He or she is the best master who allows illumination, illumining, shining, going upward spiritually without igniting it. Who is giving light to Surya? Self-illumination, Swayam Prakasham. Automatically it glows, it shines, it unfolds. I have only to facilitate. Who asked the boy in the classroom to love the girl? The boy loves. He's 20. There is a mustache. There are feelings. The other side there are girls. He looks. Does the teacher ask the boy to love the girl? Never. On the other hand, you idiot, don't look that side. He asks the boy not to look at the other side. He asks the girl not to look at the other side. But in spite of the teacher, the boy looks. Girl looks. Who teaches how to love? It is from within. Who teaches to love God? It is from within. Because God loves me. Sir, she looks at me, sir, I look at her. No, no, sir, he is looking at me, sir, therefore I am looking at her, sir. It is a mutual. God loves me, therefore I love him. Nature loves me, therefore I love nature. It is something inbuilt. And who is the best teacher? Best teacher facilitates. If because there is a class, because boys and girls are seated, because the teacher is teaching mathematics looking at the blackboard, boys and girls look at each other. The teacher is only an instrument. He only facilitates. Nature heals. If you go to a doctor for medicine, when you have cough and cold, it will take 1 week. If you don't go to a doctor, it will take 7 days. You are suffering from cold and cough, don't go to a doctor, within 7 days you are all right. Go to a doctor, he will take 1 week to set you right. Both are same. Similarly, a very good teacher heals, allows the healing, facilitates the healing without medication. What is that? Yoga. You please try to understand a point. The best doctor facilitates healing without medication. Prashanti does it. We do nothing. It's only the practice from within. Nature does the miracle. The body gets healed. Similarly, the best teacher, Swami Vivekananda, speaks of a teacher. Normally, teachers are compared to potters. A potter is a person who makes vessels. He brings the mud, adds water, makes a paste, a lump of mud, he puts it on the wheel, he rotates, he makes the plate, or he makes the potter or pot, or he makes the cup or saucer or whatever it may be. Mud is brought, water is added, it is squeezed, made a paste, placed on the wheel. What is the strain of the mud? What is the suffering of the potter? He has to go to the place, bring the mud, add water, squeeze it. It is strenuous to both. Some people make a comparison between teacher and the sculptor. Sculptor goes to the rock, cuts it, brings it, chisels it. Every part of the stone is given blows by the hammer, and then he makes a beautiful girl or a beautiful god out of it. What a strain it is. How difficult it is for the man to be chiseling, beating, hammering, and how much suffering it is for the stone to receive blow after blow. Teachers are like potters. What is the pot that he makes? He makes a pot out of mud. Mud is the student. Teacher makes an engineer out of that mud. The mud does not like it. He makes a scientist out of that mud. Mud does not like it. The teacher imposes his feelings, his ideas, his ideals, and makes a vessel. Similarly, the sculptor. Sculptor has an imagination. He has a beautiful statue in his mind. That statue he makes out of the rock. Students come like mud, like rocks. The potters and the sculptors go on dinning into their minds, and what the teacher likes, what the potter likes, what the sculptor likes, that is produced out of the student. Vivekananda says, no. It's not the correct example. A good teacher is like a gardener. Gardener brings the seed and he sows the seed. He creates discipline, fencing, so that goat will not come and eat. calf does not come and eat, cows do not come and eat, pigs do not disturb it. It is given fencing, proper protection. And that protection is discipline. The seed is allowed to sprout. He adds water to it without touching the seed. And the seed grows. If it is a neem seed, it becomes a neem tree. If the student has a desire to become a doctor, he will become doctor. It is already there in him. If he wants to become a singer, he will become a singer. That spark is there. Talent is there. Germ is there. Quality is there. What does a gardener do? He only facilitates. Students come from various sources. They have their own ideas. Who am I to interfere with that idea? Who am I to change the direction? Each person is born with a gift. My only duty is to see that the gift comes to the surface. The talent comes to the surface, the inner urge. If a person wants to become a good singer, a teacher should allow that man to shine as a good singer, sculptor, thinker, philosopher, engineer, doctor. And therefore, a gardener creates an atmosphere. Here in Prashant Kutir, we create an atmosphere. You have come from various places. The common desire is to rise to a higher level. Who am I to poke my nose? I have to create that atmosphere. When I create that atmosphere, the seed sprouts. Philosophers come to the surface. Scientists unfold their discoveries. Everything takes place. A good doctor creates an atmosphere for healing. A good teacher creates an atmosphere for feeling, for rising. And similarly, good master, Gurostu Maunam Vyakhyanam. We have prayed to Dakshinamurti. Dakshinamurti does not teach. He does not instruct. He simply sits. Gurostu Maunam Vyakhyanam, Shishyastu Chinna Samsayaha. By just sitting, by simply keeping silent, a good teacher allows the student or the disciple to unravel the mysteries. Paul Brunton, a French gentleman, came to Tiruvannamalai. And in Tiruvannamalai, there was the great Ramana Maharshi. He never speaks. He simply keeps quiet. And somebody told the French gentleman, Paul Brunton, that he is a great sage. He is capable of clearing everybody's doubt. You go to Tiruvannamalai and he came. He has so many questions in his mind, in philosophy, in spirituality, in the day-to-day life. And our Tiruvannamalai, Ramana Maharshi was seated quiet. Paul Brunton came, he sat, he looked at him, Ramana Maharshi looked at him, there was an exchange of looks, there was a communication in silence. Gurostu Maunam Vyakhyanam, silence is Mauna, commentary is Mauna, explanation is silence. He was just sitting. And one after the other, the questions came to the surface and the answers also came to the surface. Finally, he touched his feet. I got all the doubts cleared. I have the clarification. I have the illumination. And that is a good teacher. Gurostu Maunam Vyakhyanam. What does Prashanti do? At the physical level, for the physical health, we don't give any medicines, no medication. It is your own body that is put to exercise, and that only solves all the ill health problems. This is a very good doctor. Therefore, yoga facilitates healing. Teacher, he only explains. Sri Krishna Bhagavan looked at Arjun. Arjun was depressed. He was in despair. He said, no, nakanche vijayam Krishna, nacha rajyam sukhanija. I do not want to fight. If I fight, so many people will be killed. When so many people are killed, their wives become widows and their children become orphans. I will be responsible for all the destruction. I don't want to fight. He wanted to go back. And Sri Krishna made him say, stand up. Kutastva kasmalamidam vishame samupastitam anarya justam asvargyam akirtikaram Arjuna. It is not right on your part, having come to the battlefield, to run away. I will explain. What is it that he explains? If you fight, these are the advantages A, B, C, D. If you do not fight, these are the disadvantages A, B, C, D. If you marry this girl, these are the advantages and disadvantages. If you don't marry this girl, these are the advantages, disadvantages. If you choose the career of a computer analyst, these are the advantages and disadvantages. If you become a professor, these are the advantages, disadvantages. He only made the explanation. And finally, Sri Krishna asks, Arjun, for 17 chapters I have been talking to you. It is a conversation. It is a dialogue. I have tried to put forth the positive and the negative advantages and disadvantages. Yadhechasi tadhakuru. Do as you like. Yadha. Ichchasi. Ichcha means desire. As you please, tadha. So you do. Kuru means do. I have explained. I have given the total description, plus and minus, positive and negative, advantages and disadvantages. You do as you like. That's a teacher. Don't marry this girl. Marry this girl. No, it is thrusting your views on the student. You give the advantage. That is the teacher. And then, what did Arjuna say? He said, Hato. Sthitosmi gata sandeha karishye vachanam tava. My doubts are clarified. I don't have any more questions. I find fighting is good. Hatova prapyasi svargam. If you die, you will go to swarga. If you win the battle, you will rule the kingdom. Both are advantages. Everything is to our advantage. And this is how a good teacher presents the picture, plus and minus, positive and negative. And Arjuna chooses. When you come to spirituality, the great Shiva Guru, Jnana Guru, Vishnu Guru, Atma Guru, Daiva Guru, Permanent Guru, Shashwata Guru, that Sri Shiva has three manifestations. You go to any Shiva temple in this country. Number one, Shiva Lingam. Linga means chinnam, symbol. Shiva means Shubham. It is the symbol of Shubham. It is the symbol of auspiciousness. Shiva Lingam. And you pour water, it will not say yes or no. You put milk, it is quiet. You put panchamrutam, it is quiet. Stoic resignation. You scold me, no response. You praise me, no response. Somebody beats me, no response. I just, wife comes, you idiot, no reaction. You scoundrel, no reaction. You are a great person, no reaction. That is stoic resignation. Socrates was like that. His wife used to come, scold him, and Socrates, he was looking. No response. How long can she scold? 5 times? 10 times? 15 times? One day she got fed up. She went to the bathroom, collected the ditch water in a 20-liter bucket. She brought it, poured it on the head of Socrates, and he said, "Wonderful." Hitherto it was only a thunder. Now I have shower. That is stoic resignation. In the life, all problems are because we are reacting. No reaction. Shiva is like that. Shiva Linga. No reaction. He teaches us by example. Remain calm without reacting. 2. Nataraj. You will have in Chidambaram, Nataraja. Dancer. Sport. Enjoy the game of life. Whether it is a battlefield or battlefield in the house. Whether you are fighting outside or fighting with your wife. Wherever you fight, it's a sport. It's a game. Enjoy that game. Make a life of sport. Nata, Raja, the king of dance. The best sports person. Sport means you don't play the game either for victory or for loss. You just enjoy the sport. This is Lord Shiva. He plans. When you live, live like Nataraj. It's a sport. And the third one is a wonderful thing, Dakshinamurti. There are only 3 pictures of Lord Shiva. One is Sivalinga, stoic resignation, no reaction. Whatever you do, it remains the same. Second, Nataraja, while coming to the hall, while going to the dining hall, everything is a sport, smile, laughing, dancing. And the third one, be a spectator of everything. The third eye, the inward eye, the Turiya, the Atman, the Parabrahman, Aham Brahmasmi, just remain like that. All the 3 manifestations of Shiva. One is stoicism, lingam. Another is silence, Dakshinamurti. The third one is sport. You try to remember the 3 words. One is stoicism. Stoicism means stone-like without any reaction. You can experiment in the houses. You be a stone when the husband is shouting. Be a stone when the wife is criticizing. Be a stone when the students are scolding. For everything, stone. 2. I don't bother whether it is a road or anything. Dance. Children, you see, they don't walk, they only dance. They enjoy the game of life, and that is Nataraj, sport. The third one, silence. I am conscious. Consciousness is operating in Jagradavastha. Consciousness is operating in dream state. Consciousness is operating in sleep. After I wake up from the sleep, I say, I had a beautiful dream. That means you remember that. Somebody was present enjoying the dream. Consciousness. During the wakeful state, I know there is consciousness I am able to experience.